Okay, you guys, I'm back. I'm sorry, my video messed up. I was trying to turn it up and make sure it was turned up. It was turned up and messed up on me, so I had to go back in. But yeah, so yeah, you guys let me know what you think or know about the monthly cycle app. Well, not app, but the, I googled it, and the Kotex. Let me know what you think about that one and if it's a good app. Some people recommend Period Tracker. I think I used Period Tracker a few times before in the past, but I like the Pre-Mom app, and I don't know how accurate it is. But yeah, let me know about the Pre-Mom, the monthly cycle, and the Kotex, the Pre-Mom app. Not Google. I just actually have the Pre-Mom app. I don't have the monthly cycle or the Kotex. I just googled that and found that's when it was saying my cycle was, and I kind of did too, so I can see if it was average, if it was accurate or not. And both of them told me that my cycle was supposed to be in one day. So yeah, but yeah, let's take this test and see what it says. And like I told you guys, I am going to be doing another test tomorrow, which is 11 DPO, and I'll use the PregMate, trying to save this last first response, but hopefully I don't have to if I get a big fat positive today. Yeah, and I went to bed, this morning, like, very, kind of like down, so me and my husband, we prayed about it, and I was just telling him I feel like that my cycle is going to come, because I was getting some real crazy period cramps last night. They weren't bad or anything. They were mild. They weren't bad at all. It's just, I was just like, you know how you get that feeling? Like, your cycle is like, my cycle is about to come, like, right before it's coming. That's the feeling I had. And this is first response. I'm going to take the instructions out just because I messed up like on three tests yesterday. I messed up on a clear blue, which one of, watch the clear blue test. I'll tell you why later in detail. But it basically, it already had a negative line on the test line. It already had a negative on it before. And I wish that video would have went through. It actually already had a negative on it. And I hadn't even used it. I just opened it up. So watch those two, my other ones, the Equate brand was like not, it gave me a false positive. I think it was a false positive. It said it was positive, and I think it was not positive. It says 5 days sooner on that one, but this is first response. First response, do not lie, that I know of. If you, anybody else took first response, let me know in the comment section. Please, please, please. Because we women spend a lot of money on these pregnancy tests. And hey, they are not cheap. So this one says you may also collect your urine in a clean, dry cup and immerse the entire absorber tip in the urine for 5 seconds only. Okay, so this one is 5 seconds only. And then, well, I'm still holding a stick. Okay, da 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 da. Wait 3 minutes. Okay. So, we got 3 minutes on here. I'll go ahead and set my timer. You guys know it's 10. It's technically on my clock right now, it's 10:17. I've already got my first morning urine. Technically my first morning urine, because I've been asleep for 5 hours, barely. Barely, because I couldn't go to sleep, but I finally went. I was like, why am I not going to sleep? Clock. I so gotta get my iPhone back. Okay, so all I have to do is press start on that. I think I have it on vibrate, so you may not. And I'm in the restroom, so you may hear my dogs tapping, because they're loud. But yeah. Try to open it this way. First response. Why are you so hard to open? I should have brought scissors down here. Got it. Okay, so we hold it for 5 seconds, correct? Just make sure again, you guys, I'm still half asleep. 5 seconds in the hearing. So, I'll stick that right there because I'm actually going to stick the test probably back in there. So you see, this is a brand new test. It's not being used. I'm left-handed, so bear with me. It has not been used. And here we go. Oh yeah, my urine is literally right here in this cup. And I don't want to see. I do not even want to see right there. There's just too much information for y'all. And yuck. It's urine. But I'm going to stick this in here for 5 seconds. Okay. 1 Mississippi. 2 Mississippi. 3 Mississippi. 4 Mississippi. And 5 Mississippi. Okay. And then I'm going to place the cap back on it. And you guys can see. It is now registering, so I'm going to sit it right here, and then I'm going to just cover it up with that, and start my timer. And my timer is set for 3 minutes. You guys can see it. So, I will be back in just a minute. And you guys can see the results with me. So, we literally have 1 minute left. And so, you guys can see we have about 45 seconds almost left. My stomach just literally dropped. And I have my stomach hurts right now. But it does, and I'm not nervous or anything. I guess I'm just trying to not be discouraged, I guess. So 15 seconds left. Excuse me. And we will see the results. And then, of course, like I told you guys, if it is negative, then we will test again tomorrow at 11 DPO. Okay, there it is. I'm going to look at the results first, and then I'm going to let you guys look at the results to see what I see, okay? So, it is negative. Oops, turned it the wrong way. I don't see any faint line or anything. It is definitely negative. So, at this very moment, I'm not pregnant. I have to look at these tests to see, but it's definitely showing a negative. And I'll let you guys see it. I see it is showing a negative. I hope my clothes are covered, my body's covered. But yes, this one is showing negative, and it is technically on my pre-mom app. It shows 4 days past, 4 days until my next cycle. So, and these are pretty accurate. And this says it can tell you 6 days sooner than your missed period. So, at this very moment, I'm just going to say I'm not pregnant until we test tomorrow. And tomorrow, since it's 11 DPO, I'm going to, I don't know, for some reason, we always just keep looking at the test, I guess hoping that we'll catch something, but I don't see anything. So, yeah, it's definitely a negative. It's definitely a negative on here. But hopefully tomorrow we will get a big fat positive. But I just wanted to let you guys know that I'm gonna do these tests. I don't want to do these tests tomorrow, but I'm just 10 DPO, and maybe I just am not picking up a lot of my HCG level. It's not high enough. I'm not picking up. It's not picking a lot of it up right now. I don't know. I'm not going to sit here and lie. Looking at the YouTube videos, sorry. Had a call on my phone. Looking at the YouTube videos, it can get stressful when you go and take the test yourself. And so, I don't know what to say exactly right now, but I'm just not gonna get discouraged. I know that because I have high faith in God, and I do truly believe, sorry, this paper is in the way. But I have high faith in God, and I truly believe that He will make a way. The Clomid, again, I'm on my second round of Clomid, and it has not worked the first round. And I see a lot of people say that it works the second round. He has me on 50 milligram. So if you guys think that he needs to up my dose for next month, please let me know in the comment section, because he has me on 50 milligram, and I may ask him this month to up my dosage. They keep calling. I don't know who this is. They don't even have that number. It's a scam, likely. But yeah, I'm going to ask him to up my dose, possibly. If you guys let me know once you see this video, because I am going to post it probably like tomorrow or something, after I make sure everything is correct in it and like I edit it. That's my dogs. Excuse them. It's not that I'm when I watch. It's, I guess, watching the videos and seeing everybody else get so emotional. It makes me so emotional. And I'm already there because we're working on this. And we've technically been trying with Clomid since since July. So it's only been August, September, October. It's only been barely 3 months, and we've been trying with Clomid for this year. I've only tried Clomid my whole entire life one time, and that's it. And basically, I didn't know what I was doing or how to use it, and I was like 20, probably like 24. When we first tried with Clomid, and I really didn't go to my appointments like I was supposed to. I wasn't doing everything like I'm doing now. So, I mean, I just have to give it time. So technically, I feel like I'm just now actually trying with the fertility this year. So just keep my fingers crossed and keep the faith and know that everything is in God's hands, and just don't give up. That's my only thing that I can do, and hope and pray that it happens this month. If it doesn't, I'll just keep trying. You guys' videos, I'm not saying they're bad at all. They're very encouraging. This is, sometimes I get emotional because I see you guys still trying to, and it's like, I hope she gets it. I hope she gets it. And then some people do get it, and I'm like, I'm happy for her, and I hope that I'm next, you know, and then it does not happen. And I've been through a lot of things, you know, I've been through a lot, and I'm trying not to tear up right now. But yeah, I've been through a lot my years. Let me shut this door so you won't hear my dogs. I've been through a lot, and this gets emotional for me because of the things that I've witnessed and been through in my life. And I just pray that nothing that I've been through stops me from conceiving. I'm sorry, you guys. My doctor says everything is okay. So, I believe everything is okay. But I just want it to happen. And this is not something that we play with when we do these videos. And people really go through a lot. So, you guys don't give up trying. And always know that you have other people that's going through the same thing. And I mean, my doctor is telling me everything is okay. And everything looks good on my, and my tubes are open. And I really thank God because of the things that I've been through in my life. I don't want to get into details about what I've been through. But I've been talking about what I've been through lately. And it has not been easy talking about that to people. But people have been so judgmental through my years of living. And so I pretty much just kind of brush it off and just like whatever. But it has bothered me a lot in my past. It doesn't bother me now what people say. I'm like so over it and grown now because, you know, I know who I serve. I know I serve a God and he's awesome and he's mighty and he's more powerful than anybody. So I don't worry about what people say. It's just the things that I've been through and experienced in my life. And it wasn't easy at all. Let's just say that I had some rough patches in my life, and they were not something that anybody, I don't wish it on anybody. And I've came to be this person, this great person that I am now, and I've made it through that tragic and through those hard times. And I, you know, talked to my mom about it, some of it, the other day, and she sent me a message, and she was basically like, I do apologize, you know, because I never talked about it to anybody but my husband. And he understands, but he doesn't understand. So yeah, I'm just emotional right now because I want this to happen, and I want everything to go well. So you guys just bear with me on these videos, and I really do appreciate you guys for watching. And we're not gonna give up. We're gonna be strong as women, and you guys keep the faith. And right now, before I end this video, I am going to pray with everybody because we have to be strong. And my tears are just tears of happiness and tears of joy. Their tears in the beginning because I was thinking on the things I've been through and like trying to say, I'm not going to get discouraged. I'm not going to get discouraged. So, you know, let's not get discouraged. Know that we're going to conceive and we're going to make it. And everybody, you know, go out and make sure you get your body looked at. When I did it, I was thankful. I was very thankful because of the things that I've been through. God kept this body here. He kept it safe, sacred, and it's here. It's not damaged and destroyed to where I cannot conceive. I can conceive, and you don't know how many times in years I've heard that I can't conceive, or you're not gonna have any kids. It's now I just brush them off, and I'm like, they're my haters. They're my haters. They're my haters. So, and it's hurtful when you get it from your own family. Like, some people have said it, that was in my family just for hurtful things, you know, and just like, and I just brush it off, because I'm just like, they're just saying this because they're mad at me right now, but we'll get over it. But, you know, I'm thankful that this body is great. It's okay. It's not messed up. It's not damaged. I'm good, you know, I'm good. So, yeah, you guys don't give up. We're going to pray shortly in just a minute, because I want to pray with you guys this morning. I'm going to try to do this as many videos as I can, because I want to pray with you guys, okay? So let's bow our heads, close our eyes. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you right now, Father, for this morning that you've given us, God, and this day you've given us, God. God, we allow you in our lives, God, and we allow you to show up and show out like we know that you know how, God. We know that every person on here that is watching, every woman, God, that is wanting to conceive, God, we know that as long as we have faith in you and we believe that it will happen for us, God, and we cast down anything that is not like you, God, that is trying to take over our body, that is trying to pull sickness into our body, God, we cast it out into the pits of hell right now. And we claim the victory right now. And we know that it is won. We have the victory right now. Your power is so mighty, God. And we know that you can do all things. And we know that we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us, God. So we ask you right now, God, to give us strength, God. Encourage us, God. And let us be strong in you, God, and not give up and keep the faith at all times, God. We thank you right now for everyone who is watching this video right now. And we ask them to just continue to pray and press and not give up. Push, God. Push us, God. Push us, God. Let us continue to just grow more and more in you and pray and keep the faith. And at this time, God, in our life, we know that all things are possible. So we know that sometimes this year, somebody here on this live, on this video, will be conceiving with myself, God. We will conceive. Somebody this year is going to conceive. We claim the victory right now. We put it into existence, and we know, we pray that it is here right now. We claim the victory in the mighty name of Jesus, and we thank you and we love you, God, for everything that you have done, for sending your son to die on the cross for our sins, God. We thank you right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. I wanted to pray with you guys, and I hope that this video does touch someone. I thank you guys for watching, and you guys keep the faith. Happy Friday, and I'm going to go and get my stepchildren, and we're all going to have fun. We have a trail ride. I think this is my first time going on a trail ride. I haven't been on that in, well, actually not a trail ride. I've been on a trail ride. I went to a horse ride. I don't know if that's the same, but we're going there tomorrow, so we won't be back until Sunday, but I'm still going to give you guys a video for tomorrow on 11 DPO. I may stop at 12 DPO and just wait till 14 DPO and do the test. I don't know. I'll let you guys know tomorrow whether I'm going to continue doing the video. If you want me to continue doing the videos, I'm sorry. If you want me to continue to do the videos, please let me know in the comment section so that I can continue through from 10 DPO all the way through 14 DPO. And I mean, if I am pregnant, I'm going to do, well, I am pregnant. I'm going to claim it right now, that no cycle is coming and that I am pregnant. You know, we have to claim things. We have to put it into existence. So, yes, you guys make sure that you do that. I've seen some people go and buy baby clothes and just, like, set up the baby room. Like, this baby is coming. So, yeah, You guys let me know in the comment section if you want me to continue on doing the videos. I'm going to continue. If you guys do tell me, yes, continue doing the videos on through your days past ovulation, I will do that. Because you guys are my babies and you guys help me a lot with the comments, with the talking to me and keeping me encouraged. You know, you're right there with me. You're going through this with me. And I really appreciate it. All right. So you guys go like, subscribe, and comment below. Let me know in the comment section what you think. And I'm Nikki Nicole. I'm logging off.